Hello, I'm Colin Daly of Campbell Scientific in Logan, Utah. In this video, we'll show you how to get started using RTMCPro, real-time monitoring and control software. This separately purchased product is an enhanced version of the RTMC client that's included with Loggernet, Loggernet Admin, and RTDAC. We have another video tutorial on using the standard version. Some of the features I'll demonstrate are basics of placing and editing a component, expression builder, multiple data sources, using live data, multi-state alarms, alarm logs, additional screens, report and report export, and hotspots. With the standard version of RTMC development, data is displayed from a single Loggernet server's data cache. RTMCPro lets you view data from multiple Loggernet servers, Campbell Scientific data files, LNDB databases, HTTP data loggers, and virtual data sources all in one RTMC project. When RTMCPro is installed, a button is added to Loggernet's toolbar. The standard version of RTMC is still installed and available, and the RTMC runtime product supports both versions. Please note that projects developed in or converted to RTMCPro cannot be opened in standard RTMC. Let's get started. Select RTMCPro development. This looks similar to standard RTMC. You have the same alignment tools, and the save and run lightning bolt is in the same place. There are more components though, and they're organized in a toolbox. The thermometer component is in the status bar category. Just like in standard RTMC, click to select the component, and click to place it. Browse to the data source. We'll display a real-time value from the public table. To access RTMCPro's Expression Builder, click the Calculator button next to the selected data. It simplifies creating expressions, using functions, start options, aliases, and value synchronization. Functions can be inserted from the right or typed in. On the bar tab, you can set a pointer for the minimum and maximum values. Other properties are set on the Scale tab. Some of these features are covered in the Getting Started with RTMC video tutorial. Because RTMCPro can display data from many sources, the values displayed by the components in your project will not be updated until RTMC runtime is launched, unless you select Use Live Data. Let's take a look at some other RTMCPro features. This is a lightning warning system screen. The images on the right are multi-state alarms. You can specify three or more states such as off, warning, and critical. An image, sound, email, and/or run open can be defined for each state. This feature is accessed from the alarms group of the toolbox. Select multi-state alarm. Click to place it in the workspace to bring up the properties. Here you can browse to the data source. Select a normal state image. Set conditions and images, sounds, or events for multiple states. A custom email message can be sent when an alarm state is active. The Run Open option lets you set up when a command line program is executed. You'll also see in this multi-tab project that a red flag appears on the tabs with active alarms. You can also keep a log of all project alarms. Enable logging here. When this box is checked, a text entry is required of the person acknowledging the alarm. This lets you log information about who acknowledged the alarm, and they can enter other comments and observations. Let's take a look at another RTMCPro project. This project uses the reports generation feature to step through historical data and export your screen in various formats. Use these buttons to navigate through your data. Here you can enter notes to show up on the report, and click here to export it. First, we'll add another screen. Give it a meaningful name. We'll call it Report. Trends work well in reports because reports let you scroll through historic data. We'll pick a table display. This time, let's use a data file as our data source. Previously, we've used data in the cache from schedule collection. A data file lets you view data that has been collected but may no longer be in the cache. Click Add. Your choices here are Server, File, Database, HTTP Data Logger, and Virtual Data Sources. We'll select Add File Data Source. Give the source a meaningful name. I called it Data File Logan Weather. Then browse to the file. That does it. Now your RTMCPro project can access that data file for display. Here you see it in the data source browser. And we can select the data file. Table display properties lets you select which columns to display. Select from the left and add. Hold the control key to select several to be added at the same time. The Manage Columns button lets you change labels, do a calculation, or change the precision displayed. Now go to the Reports group. First, we'll add the report range. This is what designates the screen as a report. This is where you configure the time ranges of the data to be displayed. It also gives you RTMC runtime options for stepping through the data. My data is stored hourly, so I'll set the interval to 1 day. Each table will display 1 day's worth of data. The forward and back buttons will step through the data a day at a time. The report header is optional. It displays the time range currently displayed. The properties let you customize the label. The heading fits better up here. When you finish designing your report, you can specify how you want it to be exported. You can choose to have the report exported by running a batch file and/or on demand from RTMC runtime. For both batch export and RTMC runtime, you can choose from a variety of file formats. You can also select events, email, FTP, print, to be triggered when the report is exported. We'll have another video tutorial demonstrating how the CSI web server sends your data to the internet for viewing. So for now, I'll just mention that when viewing a report on the web, the export events such as email, FTP, and print are not supported. Only ping images can be exported. Let's see what this looks like in runtime. Select the Reports tab. Step backward through the data. The Current Interval button displays the current data until new data is available. The Report Export button lets you export the data in one of the file formats you set up in the development mode. Here we'll pick HTML and save the file. You can see the table just as it was in runtime mode. Scrolling down shows you the rest of the data in the report time frame, a day in our example. When exporting image files, you only see a snapshot of the screen, not data from the full report range. This project also makes use of hotspots. Here they give you an alternate way to change screens. Let's go back to our basic screen. Hotspots work well on top of other components or over an area of a background image, such as a map. We'll add some text. And make it look like a button. The hotspot component is accessed from the commands group. And we'll place it on top of the area that's supposed to be our button. When this area is clicked, you'll open a web browser to a specific web address or jump to another RTMC screen. We'll jump to another screen. Here you can select which screen. Ours is called Report. Here you can add a caption to display when the mouse hovers over the hotspot. In runtime, the only indication of a hotspot will be the changing of the cursor when over it. There are quite a few more features of RTMCPro that I haven't showed you. Look through the components in the toolbox before you start a project to see what's available. Watch for another video tutorial on getting your data displayed on a website. There are several different approaches through RTMCPro depending on the nature of the project and how familiar you are with IP communications. Please contact a Campbell Scientific application engineer to discuss your application and for answers about real-time monitoring and control using RTMCPro.